The Life of Milo. Milo is the third child and the first son of Tenzin and Pema, and grandson of Avatar Aang and Katara. He resides on Air Temple Island with the rest of his family. The young airbender has two older sisters, Jinora and Iki, and a younger brother named Roan. Welcome to the Imagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Milo. Before we begin, we publish a new video every day. So be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Early life. Milo was born in 165 AG to Tenzin and Pema and grew up as one of the last remaining airbenders in the world, the others being his father and his sisters Jinora and Iki. Korra's training. When Avatar Korra was ready to start her airbending training, Milo and his family traveled to the Southern Water Tribe to visit his grandmother and stay for the night. He was chewing on his father's head as the family arrived and hopped off of their sky bison. When Katara took him off his father's shoulders, Milo did not recognize his grandmother and quickly squirmed his way out of the hands of the strange woman. He went on to play with his sisters in the snow, claiming to be a snowbender by using his airbending to blow off a pile of snow that covered him, showering his mother, much to her annoyance. Milo and the rest of his family headed back home the next day, as Tenzin's duties as a United Republic Council member prevented them from relocating to the Southern Water Tribe as planned. Milo met Korra again not long after their last encounter, as the Avatar had run away from home and traveled to Republic City. The young boy was thrilled when he saw her again, especially after his father complied and let Korra stay on Air Temple Island in order to learn airbending with them. As an airbender, Milo was present during Korra's airbending training. While Korra was struggling with weaving her way through the airbending gates, he mimicked his father's advice by stating that Korra should try to be the leaf. When Milo participated in the meditation exercise, Tenzin singled him out as an example for Korra of how to properly meditate. However, the young boy had actually fallen asleep. Later on, when Korra destroyed the ancient training tool with her firebending in a fit of frustration and called Tenzin a terrible teacher, Milo instantly copied Korra's words, running around screaming and kicking the shambles of the now broken tool. Milo sat quietly at dinner as Councilman Tarlok entered and offered Korra to join his task force. He later enjoyed playing with Iki in a new car which was sent as a gift from Tarlok to bribe Korra. He also attended the gala that Tarlok threw for Korra along with the rest of the family, where he apparently mistook an object for a toilet, much to his father's horror and embarrassment. Upon the arrival of Mako, Bolin, Pabu, and Asami, who had come to live on Air Temple Island, Milo immediately took a liking to the new residents. After welcoming them to his domain, Milo seemed to develop a crush on Asami, calling her pretty and asking for a piece of her hair, prompting Mako to jokingly call him competition. Later on, when the members of Team Avatar were talking about saving Republic City, Milo interrupted by jumping down and passing gas on their hands. He enthusiastically agreed with them, though he had no idea what they were doing, making them all laugh. The following morning, Milo, sleeping in the bed of his parents, awoke early to the phone ringing on a bedside table and crawled over his father's face to reach it. He answered it and inquired who was calling, commenting that whoever it was had better have been important enough to justify waking him at 6 o'clock in the morning. Tenzin quickly stole the phone away from his son to take the message himself, and Milo crawled back toward his mother. The Anti-Bending Revolution. During the Equalist attack on Air Temple Island, Milo and his older sisters aided Lin Beifong in defeating several chi blockers. He displayed impressive talent in airbending, immobilizing several of the Equalists within moments. After the attack, Milo joined his sisters in welcoming their new baby brother, Roan, into the world. Shortly thereafter, he escaped the island with his family on Ugi and watched as Lin stopped the airships from following them and got captured, stating that she was his hero, to which his father sadly agreed. Despite Lin's sacrifice, Milo and the rest of his family were captured by Aman, who intended to publicly remove their bending and destroy the last airbenders. Korra and Mako swiftly came to their aid, and Korra led Milo and the rest of his family out into one of the hallways of the pro-bending arena. Tenzin led his children to find Pema and Roan, to which Milo happily exclaimed, "Prison break!" while Korra and Mako defeated Aman. Once Republic City was safe again, Milo returned to Air Temple Island with his family. He witnessed his boisterous Uncle Bumi enter the harbor with the rest of the United Forces, much to Iki's enjoyment and Tenzin's embarrassment. Miko traveled with his family, along with the rest of Avatar Korra's friends and family, to the Southern Water Tribe to have Katara restore Korra's bending. When Katara was unable to heal Korra, Milo stood by his family, who tried to tell her it would be all right. Milo later witnessed Korra use energy bending to restore Lin Beifong's earthbending and watched Tenzin praise Korra for her accomplishments as the Avatar. Journey to the Air Temples. 6 months after the events of the anti-bending revolution, Milo took part in an air scooter race with Korra and his sisters, coming in last place. Later, Milo and his family traveled back to the Southern Water Tribe to attend the Glacier Spirits Festival. After Korra dismissed Tenzin as her instructor, Milo joined his family in a journey to the Southern Air Temple, the home of his grandfather Aang. Upon arriving, Milo found a ring-tailed winged lemur and decided to name it Pokey, but the lemur escaped the young airbender's tight grasp. After settling in, Tenzin took Jinora to the statue room, but realized he had not kept a close enough watch on Milo and Iki. The two came storming in soon after, and Milo subsequently crashed into an unknown statue. The next day, Milo had successfully bonded with Pokey, carrying the lemur atop his head. As he and Jinora rolled in on air scooters to join the adults, Pema noticed that Iki was absent. Milo confessed that he and Jinora had teased Iki and she ran off. In between his explanation, he mentioned a shark squid, causing his uncle to get all worked up. Speaking of sharks, let us take a moment to introduce Surfshark VPN to you. Unlike a shark squid, Surfshark won't get you all worked up. Instead, Surfshark strives to make your digital experience as smooth and relaxing as possible by taking care of all your needs. Not only does it protect you from ID tracking by encrypting your personal data and informing you whenever your email address or password is compromised, but it also makes sure that third-party sites cannot scam you with higher prices, or that get you flooded with ads, which can be really nasty if all you want to do is play a game or watch a movie. And get this, Surfshark VPN grants you access to your favorite content on any known streaming service from wherever you are. Plus, you can use it on any device you like, be it on just one or more devices. And you have a 30-day money-back guarantee. So what are you waiting for? Go to surfshark.deals/amagi and enter the promo code AMAGI to secure your new VPN and get 83% off with 3 extra months for free, and experience a relaxing time of binge-watching your favorite shows or movies during quarantine with guaranteed security as a bonus. Security is a good note, as that's where we left off in our video. Together with his siblings, Tenzin built a search party for Iki and went looking for her. When Milo saw his father return with his sister late the next day, he smiled at her, and upon his mother's insistence to speak, announced that he was glad she had returned, a statement echoed by his eldest sister and readily accepted when she proposed that the three of them go play airball. Over the next few days, Milo started trying to train his lemur, Pokey, though without much success as he had failed to establish dominance over the animal and over-rewarded the creature even for bad behavior. After he failed to teach Pokey how to roll over, he accepted his father's offer to teach him how to become a master trainer. Milo eventually succeeded in training Pokey, giving a demonstration for the rest of his family. After the animal sat and rolled over on Milo's command, the young airbender was complimented by his father, who expressed his faith in the boy for training Pokey. Milo countered that he did not just train Pokey, but had extended his teachings to all the lemurs. To prove his point, he blew his whistle, prompting all the lemurs to execute several patterns in the air upon Milo's direction. Although impressed with his son, Tenzin realized that he had gone too far in making Milo a master trainer and suggested that the boy forgot about the training discipline for a while and just enjoyed playing with his lemur. Relieved, Milo readily took his father up on the suggestion, admitting that the training had tired him out. As he ran off with Pokey, he blew his whistle a last time, signaling the other lemurs that they were free to do what they wanted again. At the Eastern Air Temple, Milo listened in boredom to the itinerary his father had come up with for the day, which included visiting a lot of the temple's ancient places. His attitude changed completely, however, after Korra arrived at the temple, and he excitedly ran over to greet her and hug her. However, as she brought the family up to speed with the current events they had missed due to their vacation, Milo stared at her in shock. After it became apparent that Korra needed to cross over to the spirit world, Milo tried to assist her and his father. When they were meditating on one of the grassy fields of the temple, Milo was tasked with ringing a ceremonial bell while Iki used her airbending to operate a horn. However, when Tenzin and Korra failed to enter the spirit world, Milo was chided by his father for ringing the bell on the wrong intervals. As Tenzin left, Korra assured him that the bell playing was just fine, a compliment he appreciated greatly by ringing his bell again. Milo continued to trail his father and Cora whenever they went to meditate, though he was shocked when he overheard his father confess that he had never been to the spirit world before. When Jenora told her dragonfly bunny spirit friends that it was all right to reveal themselves, Milo was excited to witness the spirits and immediately chased after them to play together. Awaiting the return of Cora and his family, Milo was playing with Iki in the temple's garden under the supervision of his mother. He was excited to see his father return, but grew saddened when he saw his sister's spiritless body. Milo returned to Air Temple Island with his mother and Iki, while Tenzin, Bumi, Kaya, and Team Avatar set out to stop Unalaq before harmonic convergence came. From the balcony of the island's tower, he watched how Vatu, merged with Unalaq, laid waste to the city, declaring the large spiritual form to be a monster, though excitedly commented upon the arrival of Korra's gigantic astral projection. Post-harmonic convergence. 2 weeks after harmonic convergence, Milo was playing together with his youngest sister and Pabu when Bumi came running and asked where Tenzin was. After Iki called for their father, Milo listened with interest to his uncle's story about his airbending feats. Though when he failed to prove his skill, Milo frowned and left him on the porch to follow the rest of the family inside to enjoy dinner. During the meal, however, Bumi did not let up on his attempts to try to airbend, and Milo complied to his request to have something thrown at him by launching a plate at him, looking on in shock when Bumi caught the object in a ball of air. The next day, Milo watched his uncle trying to bend on command to no avail. The revelation that other airbenders were emerging excited the young airbender, and he began fantasizing about being a commander of his own air army. When Asami arrived that evening at Air Temple Island, in the Future Industries airship the team would be using to travel toward Ba Sing Se, Iki and Milo excitedly created air scooters to take a tour of the transport. However, when they learned that they would need to remain at the temple while Jenora would accompany the group to the Earth Kingdom, they became upset and demanded an explanation from their parents. Kaya eased their jealousy by pointing out that they were needed on the island to provide guidance for any new airbenders in the city. The prospect of possibly telling others what to do excited Milo, and he dropped the issue. When the team embarked on their journey, he waved them off, yelling that he would miss them. Later, as Milo and Iki were helping the airbenders get acclimated to Air Temple Island, they were approached by an airbender who claimed his name was Yoru, and that he had heard the island was where the new benders could go. Milo told him that he heard correctly and watched as the stranger demonstrated his bending. That evening, Milo watched as Daw and another bender failed to get through the training gates, yelling at them and telling Daw to be the leaf. The young airbender was soon left in amazement as he watched Yoru pass through the gates with little problem, calling him a leaf. The man bowed to Milo, saying that a student was only as good as his master, to which the young boy respectfully bowed back before turning to Kaya as she arrived to inform the group of Tenzin's finding and planned training of new airbenders at the Northern Air Temple. Milo, Iki, Kaya, Pema, and the new airbenders later arrived at the Northern Air Temple to resume training with Tenzin. During the obstacle course, Milo launched watermelons at the trainees with his bending. Shortly after the course, a frustrated Tenzin put Milo in charge of the training, who quickly jumped to the task, telling the recruits that one of them would not make it out alive after training was complete. After they learned of Jenora being in danger, Milo and Iki gathered two flying bison on Bumi's request. Afterward, Milo and the airbenders made their way to a bison rustler's camp where Jenora, Kai, and bison calves were being held. Following on Bumi's speech, Milo declared that no airbender would be left behind, and they charged into the rustler's camp. He was able to leap an earthen wall on an air scooter and knock down the rustler's leader, Ganbat, with a blast of air, along with another one who had tried to knock him down with a ramp of earth. After the rescue was successful, Milo briefly sat on a baby bison's head. Sometime later, Milo answered Bolin's radio call from Zhaofu. He asked who was calling, though when told once more that it was Bolin, he answered that Bolin was currently not at the air temple, asking if he could take a message. Upon being asked to get his dad, Milo revealed that Tenzin was outside with the bison and inadvertently distracted Bolin from their urgent situation by revealing that they had found an entire herd of bison calves. When Cora took over and ordered Milo as his commanding officer to get his father, the young boy snapped to attention and left to find Tenzin immediately. Although Milo returned with Tenzin, they were too late to evacuate before the arrival of the Red Lotus. Milo asked his father what was so alarming about the sight of the four people in the airship that had appeared, though was merely told that they needed to get everyone out of the temple. Staying close to his father, they met up with the rest of their family and tried to reach the bison to escape, though found themselves cornered by Zaheer. They were all rounded up in one of the temple's courtyards, though when Tenzin blew Zaheer, Gazan, and Minghua back, Milo was ordered to follow Jinora and the others toward the stables and leave the temple. Although they managed to reach the stables, the bison took off without them after they got spooked by one of Pali's combustion attacks, leaving them at the mercy of the firebender. Milo and the other occupants of the temple were taken by Pali to a series of caves, where they were held captive by Red Lotus sentries, restrained to the floor by platinum chains. At Jinora's gesture, Milo told the guards he needed to go to the bathroom. After Jinora airbent at the guard, sending his keys flying, Milo used his bending to send them in Opal's direction, allowing her to unlock her chains. When the guards caught them beginning their escape, they were attacked by the approaching Team Avatar. With the men defeated, they were all freed and left the cave with Milo and his siblings running toward Tenzin and hugging him. As Korra dueled Zaheer, Milo and the other airbenders followed Jinora into a circle and helped bend up a tornado, freeing Korra and allowing her to slam Zaheer to the ground. The Avatar, however, had been substantially weakened by a metallic poison, leaving her in a perilous state. Milo watched in worry as Su Yin tried to bend the substance out, but was soon left smiling as Korra was saved upon completion of the task. 2 weeks later on Air Temple Island, Milo waited with his family, the Beifongs, Lord Zuko, and President Raiko, as Asami wheeled out a debilitated Korra. Milo jumped on the Avatar's lap, telling them Jinora was already in the temple, which he said smelled like shoe trees, prompting Iki to correct him that they were actually sandalwood trees. They were helped up the stairs to Jinora's ceremony by means of an earthen ramp by Lin. Inside, Milo sat in the front row and watched as his oldest sister's tattoos were revealed and she was appointed as an airbending master. 174 AG. Together with his family, Milo attended the grand reopening of Republic City's Central City Station, where he stood rather bored while picking his nose during President Raiko's speech. Afterward, he returned to Air Temple Island together with his family, Prince Wu, Asami, Lin Beifong, Mako, and the presidential couple. During dinner, he announced that he was sure that Korra would no longer recognize him when she arrived. Upon asked why he thought that, he announced with pride that he had grown up to be a man, though he failed to impress his youngest sister with the remark. When an air acolyte notified the gathered group of the arrival of a ship from the south, he joined everyone else on the dock to greet Korra, who was scheduled to arrive. Though he stopped his activity in shock when it became apparent that Korra had left the Southern Water Tribe 6 months prior, leaving everyone to wonder about her whereabouts. Milo and his two sisters were later tasked by Tenzin to track down Korra and bring her to Republic City. When their father stressed the importance of the task and asked if he could count on them, Milo readily stated that he could count on him, though expressed worry about the reliability of his sisters, which earned him glares from Iki and Jinora. Finding the Avatar. The next day, Milo and his two sisters prepared Pepper to leave on their quest. While Iki was putting some of their luggage away on the bison's saddle, Milo airbent two bags on the bison, one of which hit his sister in the face, prompting her to chase him. Overhearing his mother say she had prepared food for them, Milo was quick to reject the provisions, declaring that they had no need for it as they were going to be living off the land. When Pema revealed that she had also prepared his favorite snacks, sweet buns with happy faces, Milo quickly dropped his attitude and accepted the food. Upon opening one of the wrapped sweet buns, however, he discovered that the happy face had been smudged, which made it inedible for him, though he was told by his mother that such things happened in the wild. He hugged her goodbye before mounting Pepper to depart on their journey. When Tenzin reminded everyone that Jinora was in charge, Milo rejected her authority, stating that he answered to no one, even if said person had her airbending mastery tattoos, and promptly ordered their search party to move out. As the siblings made a first stop at a stupa stop atop a mountain near a village, Milo thankfully used the opportunity to go to the bathroom. Upon his return, he was informed by Iki that Jinora's spirity powers were broken, as she had been unable to locate Korra. As Jinora snapped at Iki that her abilities were fine and that she merely needed some quiet time, Milo dismissed her grievance as something she just needed to work through and pull herself together for, and announced that he and Poki would venture into the nearby town to ask around for Korra. When Iki wanted to join him, he told her to be silent, minimizing her help to carrying the picture of Korra he had drawn. Being complimented on his lifelike portrait of the Avatar, Milo noted that there were a lot of things that his sister did not know about him. In town, Milo asked an old woman, among others, if she had seen Korra, guiding her attention to the drawing Iki was holding. Upon being told by the woman that he was adorable, Milo grew offended and corrected the elder that he was dangerous instead, though was labeled dangerously cute due to his cheeks in the end. Embarrassed, Milo ordered his sister to forget about the encounter, and the two siblings split to cover more ground. Their search turned out fruitless after the three siblings moved on to the next town with the same results. During one of their other searches, Milo discovered a young girl selling flowers to passersby. Soaring down from the roof he was on, he landed near her and asked if she could be trusted. Receiving a positive answer, he leaned toward her in a conspiring manner and whispered that he was on a top-secret mission to locate the Avatar, inquiring if the girl had seen her. Although she had not seen Korra, the girl was impressed by his quest, leading Milo to brag about the dangerous and crazy things he had encountered. He introduced himself and asked in a flirtatious manner what he should call her besides beautiful. Before Milo could say anything more to the girl who had introduced herself as Tuyen, he was interrupted by Iki, who teasingly commented that he had found himself a girlfriend. Although Milo ordered her to leave, his sister approached and told him that Jinora had been looking for him as they were moving on to the next town. Milo was subsequently offered a flower by Tuyen, who wished him good luck on his mission. As she caressed his hair while passing him away, Milo stared after her with a love-struck expression. Noticing his sister standing nearby, he snapped out of it and sarcastically thanked her for her intervention, as she had chased away the love of his life. The trio made their way to a small fishing town, where they repeated the routine. As Milo sauntered past a fishing shop, he noticed a picture of Korra hanging on the wall and excitedly called for his sisters. As Jinora dismissed his finding as just a photo, Milo defended it by pointing out that it was at least something, and when the fishmonger replied that Korra had been there 6 months prior, he smugly added that it was a good old-fashioned lead. However, when the fishmonger could not tell them where Korra had gone to afterward, Milo turned on his sisters, blaming them for not pulling their weight on their mission, and stormed off. During their next midday stop, Milo played with Pokey, though when Iki asked if he had seen their food supply, he admitted that he had thrown it all into the river, declaring that they should be hunting for their meal instead. He waved off Iki's complaint that vegetarians did not hunt, and promptly left with his ring-tailed flying lemur to find something to eat in the surrounding woods. The duo was able to find several purple berries, though they turned out to be poisonous upon consumption. Milo and Pokey staggered back to Jinora, who was meditating, though stopped her activity to inquire about her brother's health. Although clutching his stomach, Milo insisted that he was fine and offered his eldest sister the bag with berries for lunch. However, before he could say anything else, he ran for the bushes and threw up, though he kept on insisting that it was merely because he ate too much. As he rejoined Jinora, he learned that Iki had run off and grew angry as it complicated his mission. Storming off, he was berated by Jinora for continuously thinking finding Korra was solely his quest as opposed to their joint endeavor as a family. Milo and Jinora found Iki at an outpost of the military in the Earth Empire, and after quickly incapacitating the two soldiers who held their sister, the siblings mounted Pepper and set course for the foggy swamp. When Jinora failed to sense Korra there as well, Milo commented that not getting any results was to be expected when listening to Iki. As Pepper turned to leave, the bison was pulled down by vines, forcing them all to crash land in the murky waters below. Milo swiftly deposed of the vines with his airbending, though wondered why the vines had grabbed them. When Iki saw therein a sign that she had been right for wanting to search the swamp, and subsequently exchanged words with Jinora, Milo curtly commented that his next mission would be boys only. Milo and Iki started another verbal battle with each other, during which he stated that he was tired of listening to her, though the argument was cut short when Jinora felt Korra's presence nearby. The siblings promptly stopped bickering and found their way to the banyan grove tree. Discovering Korra at its base, the three siblings soared down and enveloped the Avatar in a hug. Upon being asked how they had been able to find her, they explained that they could not have found her without working together. After being introduced to Toph Beifong, whom Milo recognized due to her crankiness, age, and blindness, they implored Korra to return with them, as she needed to stop Kuvira, who was taking over the Earth Kingdom. They all returned to Toph Beifong's dwelling, where the siblings witnessed Korra purifying herself from the residual traces of mercury in her body before departing with her on their journey home. En route to Zaofu, Milo grew excited about the prospect of Korra fighting Kuvira. Upon learning that Korra wished to avoid conflict and reason with the Metalbender, he asked in shock why they had gone through all the trouble to save her if she was not going to beat someone up. Arriving at the home of the Metal Clan, he excitedly commented that they had made it, though his mood fell when he noticed that Kuvira's entire army was gathered before the gates of the city. Regardless, he and the others made it into the city. Spending the night, he was woken up by Kuvira's announcement over the city's communication system, alerting every citizen that Suyin had been arrested. Although Iki pleaded for them to be allowed to help, they were ordered to stay behind with Juan and Batar, much to his disappointment. Under the artist's supervision, Milo painted a lifelike portrait of himself as an emperor, though was chided for being a pedestrian, as he had failed to show his inner Milo. The craft session was interrupted, however, when Jinora called for their help, much to his excitement. Taking the reins of Pepper, he ordered the bison to dive into the heart of the whirlwind Jinora and Opal had created to keep Kuvira's army at bay. Sending a barrage of wind blasts at the incoming soldiers, he enabled the two to safely get Korra on board before steering the bison away. Returning home. Along the way, Milo relinquished the reins of Pepper to Opal. Upon arriving at Air Temple Island, he excitedly ran up to his parents, shouting that they had returned and brought Korra with them. Warmly hugging his mother, Milo turned to his father upon hearing him say that he was proud of them, inquiring if he was proud enough to get his airbending mastery tattoos. Displeased due to being denied, Milo crossed his arms, eliciting giggles from his mother. Defending Republic City. After President Raiko ordered a mandatory evacuation of Republic City due to Kuvira's imminent attack, Milo retreated to his room with his two older siblings and mother to prepare their suitcases. After talking it over with her family, however, they all decided to stay, reasoning that Republic City was their city, and it was going to need all the help it could get. As an extra motivation, Milo noted that only cowards fled their fate. Sharing a family hug with his father after Pema alerted him of their decision, Tenzin told Milo, Jinora, and Iki that they could help the other airbenders by monitoring the progress of the military of the Earth Empire from above, to which Milo added that Kuvira was going to regret the day that she messed with him. A week later, the arrival of Kuvira's troops imminent, Milo and the other airbenders gathered on rooftops from where they had an overview of the gathered United Forces troops and the direction from which Kuvira would arrive. He was shocked to see the approach of an enormous mecha suit, and after witnessing it destroy the United Forces battleships with the spirit energy cannon it carried, he retreated toward the Future Industries factory where the Hummingbird mecha suits were being assembled. When he was not elected by Korra to be part of her stealth team of airbenders, Milo was disappointed and asked her for clarification. Being explained that his flatulence was too much of a liability on the mission and required everyone to be silent, he yelled that he could be quiet, though when he simultaneously farted, he noted in embarrassment that he understood her reasoning. He was later forced to run for his life, however, when Kuvira traced Batar Jr.'s radio call toward the factory and blew it up with her spirit energy cannon. Milo managed to survive the explosion and emerged from the rubble with everyone else when Bolin lifted a large piece of concrete. While Asami and Varric attempted to adapt the prototypes of the Hummingbird mecha suits in Asami's office to get them airborne, he and the other benders faced Kuvira and her army in an attempt to stop them, or at the very least, slow them down. As they ran past a paint store in the city, Milo got an idea and blasted down the door. When Lin asked him what he was doing, he ordered everyone to grab the paint and find balloons. Following his instructions, he and the other airbenders equipped themselves with balloons filled with paint. Upon reaching the enormous mecha suit, Milo ran up to its platinum arm and catapulted his balloons against the suit's windows. Ordering the others to do the same, they managed to momentarily obscure Kuvira's vision from inside the suit and enable the earthbenders on the ground to tie down the suit's legs. As Bolin gave the signal, Milo and the other airbenders blasted the suit with air currents in an attempt to topple it over. The suit managed to stabilize itself, however, forcing Milo and the others to flee when Kuvira aimed her spirit cannon at them. Sitting dazed on the ground, Milo gathered his bearings before they all retreated to Asami's office, where a new plan was formed. The benders would relentlessly attack the mecha suit to distract Kuvira and enable the two Hummingbird mecha suits to land on the enormous machine and cut a hole in it without being crushed. When Kuvira aimed her cannon at Korra, Milo, his airbending family, Kai, Daw, and another female airbender worked together to form a tornado in their wake and swoop down on the weaponized arm of the suit, knocking it out of balance and distorting its aim. While the other airbenders soared around the suit, Milo attached himself to the windows of the cockpit, breathing on them and startling Kuvira. He managed to avoid being squashed by the suit and scared off. As the energy cannon was fired at him, he turned out of the way, which left the beam to travel on toward Jinora and Tenzin. Landing safely atop a roof with Iki, Milo saw his unconscious father and eldest sister plummet down. While Iki saved Jinora, Milo dove after his father and positioned himself underneath him. By airbending at the ground from his feet, he managed to break both their falls and they landed safely. Ultimately, their diversion worked, and while Korra, Mako, Bolin, Lin, and Su Yin managed to infiltrate the enormous suit, Milo made his way through the streets of the city with his family. Before they could reach a safe place, however, a wave of energy caused by the firing of the spirit energy cannon inside Republic City's spirit wilds bore down upon them and they were forced to flee inside the hall of a nearby building, where they all huddled down and Tenzin protected his children against the incoming smoke. As the smoke cleared out, Milo followed his family to the heart of the spirit wilds, where now a new spirit portal was located. Realizing Korra and Kuvira were nowhere to be found, Milo, Team Avatar, and their allies set out to search the area for the Avatar. Soaring around, Milo surveyed the area from the sky, though to no avail. He was surprised to see all the spirits return a moment later and, when Korra supported Kuvira while emerging from the spirit portal, he was happy to see his friend again. After Kuvira was handcuffed and escorted away, Milo hugged Korra along with the rest of Team Avatar. Milo later attended the wedding between Varric and Zhu Li at Air Temple Island, though slept through the ceremony. After dinner, when the dance floor was open, Milo once again fell asleep while resting his head on the table he was sitting at. Spirit Crisis. Sometime later, Milo joined his family at the temporary evacuee camp that had formed on the outskirts of Republic City. He listened to Zhu Li handing out that day's instructions to all the volunteers, but became distracted when Korra and Asami, having returned from their vacation to the spirit world, entered the tent. When Tenzin brought Korra up to date with current events and mentioned that President Raiko's popularity had dropped to such a low point that even a flying lemur could run against him and win the upcoming election, Milo presented Pokey to his father, enthusiastically declaring, "Pokey for president." After the battle between the spirits and the triple threat triad, Milo, along with Tenzin, Jinora, Iki, Kai, and Ryu, joined Korra on her mission into the spirit world, where she hoped to be able to reason with the spirits and convince them that the Avatar was and always would be the bridge between the spirit and physical worlds. He slept through the flight toward the portal, but as they neared their destination, he was rudely awoken by Iki with an elbow to the chest. As he roused from his slumber, he disorientedly asked where they were and if they had crashed. As his sister pointed out that they were about to enter the spirit world and that she reckoned he should be awake for that, he drowsily agreed with her, stretching as they crossed over into the spirit world. When they discovered that the once vibrant field of flowers that Republic City's spirit portal led to was now barren and seemingly burned down, Milo sarcastically thanked Iki for waking him up to see the wasteland. As they explored the place, wondering what could have caused such a level of destruction, Milo and the others were attacked by vines of the scorched spirit flowers. He rode to safety atop Ugi on his air scooter, commenting that it was the last time he visited the spirit world. Ugi rushed them all back to safety by leaving the spirit world, though before they could recover from their ordeal, they discovered that Raiko had ordered the United Forces to erect a perimeter around the portal, much to their dismay. Some days later, Milo and his family were discussing Raiko's decision to deploy the United Forces to occupy the land surrounding the portal. As his sisters and father got riled up about the situation, Milo suggested to gather all the airbenders and march on the portal. His father agreed with his idea, suggesting to lead a peaceful protest march to rally the city behind them and pressure Raiko to withdraw his troops. And while Milo had intended to gather the airbenders to attack, he supported his father's suggestion. Did you enjoy the video? Be sure to tell us in the comments. And make sure to subscribe. And check out these other great videos from the Imagi. If you'd like to support me, you can also subscribe to my personal channel. See you guys tomorrow!